guys, Spy Hiney here with, at long last, another Animorphs vlog. This is book 13, The Change. 13 really is an unlucky number because every time I tried to make a video on this book, something has gone wrong. So hopefully 50th time is a charm. Why am I in the woods? Well, because my house is a jungle, so might as well just go out into the woods because it looks nicer. So my life has been absolute shambles because I graduated from college and I have no idea what I'm doing, so that's why it's been taking me so long to get these videos out. So anyway, before anything else goes wrong, my arm is getting tired. So in this book, this is the book where Tobias regains his morphing ability. Banging ahead of myself. So we start with Tobias decides to visit his old school, sees his friends, and sees Rachel, and then he sees a note in Rachel's hand that says that she won some sort of like scholarship or merit thing or something like that. And there's gonna be an awards ceremony, which, being a hawk, he can't really attend. So she didn't tell him that. She didn't tell him that she won the award because she knew he wouldn't be able to attend the ceremony. And Tobias does not like that she hid that from him because he doesn't like when people feel sorry for him. So that's a minor bit of tension going throughout the story. By sheer coincidence, there's bees. So then, by sheer coincidence, he ends up meeting some Hork-Bajir who are trying to escape from the Yerks. He and Rachel manage to save them. They're Jerahami and his wife, Ket Halpak. I completely butchered that, I'm sure. So Jera and Ket are trying to find a safe place to raise children. And Tobias is like, well, where on earth is safe from the Yerks? And then he gets this image beamed into his head by sheer coincidence. And now he knows the location of a secret Great Valley. Convenient! Oh, yeah, the Alamist. The Alamist is behind all this, and Tobias is very mad about being used as a puppet. So he's like, you know what? If I'm going to do this, I'm gonna get something out of it. So why don't you make me human again in exchange for this? And the Alamist is like, sure, yeah, whatever. So they go through with this incredibly exhausting and dangerous mission. The Yerks are pulling out all stops. They even start a forest fire, and then they have like troops of Taxons and Hork-Bajir and human controllers all after them. So, oh, my battery's low, that's great. So in all this mess, Tobias has been running into normal mundane earth predators, and a raccoon is about to eat him alive, because apparently that's what raccoons do, is they eat their prey alive. Yeah, that's fun. So as he's about to be devoured by this raccoon, the Alamist is like, so do you want that payment now? And Tobias is like, yes, please, that would be great. And then he's like, congratulations, you can morph again. And Tobias is like, what? So he morphs the raccoon, and the raccoon is like, fuck this shit, I'm out. And he leaves. So Tobias is safe, he rejoins his friends and goes back to the mission. And they fake Jera and Ket's death so that the Yerks will stop chasing them. And they do this by jumping off a cliff only to be rescued by Marco. So, ah! Butterfly! Butterfly! It's pretty! Hello! Okay. Oh my gosh. Anyway, finally, after all that, everybody's happy. There are some free Hork-Bajir in the world at last, and they're going to be bringing more Hork-Bajir into the world, and everybody's happy. And then Tobias gets teleported again, this time to the past. And he meets his younger self. And he's like, oh, this is just a dream, go back to sleep. And then his younger self's like, wait, if this is a dream, how can I go back to sleep? So he acquires his younger self, and that's how he is able to regain his human form in some form. So he surprises Rachel by morphing human and going to her award ceremony. The fact that nobody realized that this kid who's been missing for months has suddenly turned up again really shows how awesome Tobias' life as a human was. Yeah, he definitely, like, chose to be stuck in Morph. Like, I'm pretty sure it's not even my headcanon at this point. I think that's just canon. Like, I would choose to be a hawk too. But anyway, now that he has a human form, he and Rachel now no longer have the whole species barrier to worry about. Which I think is the main thing that he was hung up on. So, everything's right with the world again. Except for the Elemis being a huge dick. But, whatever.